I want to introduce myself. My name is Mechtild Meinike. I've been in the planetarium for more than 40 years. First in the planetarium in Halle Kaena and space flight planetarium Halle, and since 2008 in the planetarium Merseburg in a mixture of voluntary and freelance. This is my first talk in English. I hope you can all understand me. For a few years, I've been working at the University of Applied Science in Merseburg in various projects as a coordinator, amongst other things, digital education and culture. And since the beginning of the year, as a research associate of IMVIR project. Last year, I had the opportunity to apply for my own project with my own ideas on at the Ministry of Education, and I will give a first overview and then go into details on individual project parts. The objective of the project is the development of interesting teaching and learning content for immersive media and virtual spaces. Regional network partners have come together for this project, which benefit in different ways. In addition to the three departments of Merseburg University and various educational institutions, these include museums, companies and multiples in source of Saxony-Anhalt. The development of interactive teaching and learning units takes into account the ancillary needs of network partners and other subsequent users. The project is interdisciplinary and addresses equally the areas education in the digital world, culture and media in digital transformation, and economy, science, and work 4.0 of the digital agenda for the state Saxony-Anhalt. It has been possible to raise funds towards the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Economy. The project goes over 2 years. The virtual space should be understood with exploratory and playful aspects as an area of experimentation and action. Our focus is on tests of different immersive projection options in virtual rooms. At the same time, virtual space becomes a digital research laboratory. The project has a long, long history. I like to work interactively in direct contact with the audience. My request has always been a lively live moderation had integrated various media. In 2005, for example, I had a project on a virtual cosmos with two professors. We are the large number of video clips and cosmic motifs we have created. In addition, a video film, Cosmic Metamorphosis, arose from the material. This movie was 20 minutes long and asks questions of the effects of intelligence in space. It was followed by an interactive planetarium program. Starry Sky itself experienced a program without a plan, a question and answer game with an audience. Luxina, and the program with Luxina to the Stars, which is a hand puppet with interact with the audience. In 2011-2012, I developed three sci-fi short films with puppets of the working group The Weltraum Detektive and the Space Detectives, which were then awarded the State Video Prize. These clips were made in the trick box of the Station for Citizen TV. The steps in the guideline for other work on creation of multimedia elements to support live moderation. The first first situated for specific target groups is another aspect. The planetarium is a place for an individual experience in the community. The question is, what does the audience need? And the content must be expensive. We do not want to be a similar program. It's an important thing. In 2016, we have a self-built Fulldome system in the planetarium in an 8-meter dome. We have two projectors and user software for 18,000 euro. It's a Fulldome system. Since then, the planetarium has three subtitles that show the expanded workspace: Life Planetarium, Science Theater, and Creative Space. We had 7,000 visitors last year, a third of some are students. The planetarium belongs to the city of Merseburg. The Southlands Association realized the operation and provides the speakers for the shows and lessons. That was the prehistory. And now, since January, project in there. What do we want to do? We have ambitions. Various faculties, technical professors specialized in evaluation and usabilities and sociology, and one person from the school laboratory for chemistry work in the project. The production is supported by employees of the film and sound studio of the university. We have a multimedia competence center. And these steps are very important for us. The first step is the creation of immersive and interactive teaching and learning content for an hour. And planetarium for school and university and public. We are produced prototypes. The finished material is used to some open education resources. The second step is content for use in the museum. The third step is the visualization of science data in immersive and interactive teaching and learning units. It's a network project. Project manager Zeugner. He comes Friday evening to the Fulldome Festival. And so the collaboration of the university. He works with students as assistants in this project. The contents are development for very interested students. These are not students in game design, but to our studies kind of media education and studies. Students are learning technical writing on our university. There are no credit points for this work. German Chemical Museum and the Cultural History Museum Schloss Merseburg also partner in this project, and for the public relations platforms and this partner. In my work, I supervise the multitude of artistic projects in Planetarium, and I'll give you a list for ideas what Planetarium Merseburg is. It. Planetarium, Life Planetarium, Science Theater, and Creative Space is a life interaction, is a place for learning, for experience, and creative space. Virtual reality, in the sense of the project, has everything positions in this part. What is project. We are some points listed. We are in Planetarium, can event space, experimental space. We are a testing area for other things, and our guideline for work Planetarium are the art space of future, as Thomas Grauber from Planetarium Hamburg. You know, Thomas from Medienbogen here, Cultural Hemisphere, is the dome. Planetarium's development future culture is a very good opera house and theater by Mickey Raymond. We are in Planetarium as a virtual immersive interaction multi-user application as a teaching and learning form in their project. This is the idea. For our work is underlying basic theories of play and game in theory, and learning about your own actions with emotion and imagination. We have other guidelines for other work and the reflection of social conditions and requirements, and game provides its horizon or models that will done either as another idea for other work. We have in the dome in Merseburg Unity assets tested, and this in live interactivity together with all the organizers. This is the room. In playful assets, in researching and exploring assets, in immersive and with scientific basic, yeah, creation of new content and content aesthetic possibilities and experience. This is the project shuttle created for modules, the modules over 2 years. Approach for modules 1 and 2 is a method, serial scale. Begin the story and step by step, right? We come to the final product, a prototype product for interaction setting for 15 minutes for teaching lessons and learning concepts in resolution, polyhopon, connections, and lexicon. This is in module 1, a serious game set, titled Bang Boom. And here is the regulatory process and power tools process visualized. In this module, I developed the chemical technical process for the history. Important is the storytelling. It needs a story. The students developed the virtual world for the dome and VR glasses. We worked in the first step with the controller and keyboard in the dome. This is the dome sign. And this character design is a professor. Model 2 is some connection of basic chemistry, astronomy, and history linked by a scenario which is located in a historical room in the town of Figgers and place in Saxony-Anhalt. Here the story is finished and we are working on the production concept for visualization. This image is a fantastic immersive image with a lot of details in depth. We know about the difference between dome and the arc wave projection, and we'll take this into account in the development. The finished products from module 1, 2, and also 4 are made available via the education server on the state of Saxony Anhalt as open education sources. I just want to name module 3. We are in the preparatory phase. This module is not for the dome. It's module for VR glasses. Module 5 is the virtual for instruction. Now the book about how knows model cabinet is a complex module. The Barockhall of Melrose was Carlos of Duchess in Melrose Castle. Melrose was until 1925 the seat of the Prussian provincial government. The administrative location was relocated to Berlin in 1925. As a result, the Melrose cabinet went into Berlin possessions. It does not come back to Merseburg. Today, the Melrose cabinet is installed in the Bode Museum in Berlin. This week was photographic shot of the Merseburg cabinet. There used to be over 200 jewels and jewelries made of gold, gemstones, and porcelain figures. Of these, only 5 have been deciphered. So the objects are now in Dresden Zwinger, Armageddon. This photogrammetry and reconstructed in PC. As Julian will associate a modern mirror cabinet in the virtual world with an interactive scene. In Merseburg Castle, there is an empty room in which the virtual mirror cabinet for VR glasses is to be installed. Module 4 is the second year of the project. We will try to integrate science data from a citizen science project into a teaching and learning content. In Halle, there is an initiative of citizens which measure particulate matter in the air and puts the readings on the internet. For students, current public science is to be experiences to this part. Digitale Themen e.V. is an association that allows citizens to build sensors for the measurement. The company Ecotire is a partner with experience in visualization of coordinates related data. The goal is again the development of content for the planetarium and the VR glasses in the school. Planetarium is being developed because the planetarium has always being a place not only for astronomy and space travel, but for my topics and for many topics and contexts. The planetarium is a fantastic immersive and social interaction space that works without the VR glasses. I hope that the next year we'll be able to show the first finished modules in the dome and or in VR glasses for the Fulldome Festival. I will report about progress of the project with 4 parts next year. Thank you for your attention and your understanding for my speech mistakes.